I finally unlocked the Opal camo for Black Ops 6 Zombies, and I gotta say, this has to be one of the most easiest camo grinds I've done in a very long time. Okay, so the way to unlock all of the military camos for the shotguns, and all you have to do is get 2,000 critical kills with the shotguns, and my god, this has to be the easiest thing I've ever done in my life. But when you're done with the military camos, all you gotta do is the special camos, which for example, for the Marine SP, which is to get 300 kills with a rare rarity or higher, and also get 300 hipfire kills with the shotgun. Because god damn, this gold camo does not look bad at all, even though multiplayer is much more better. And the way to unlock gold camo is to get 10 kills rapidly 15 times. And I gotta say, was it worth it? Maybe. Good morning everybody, my name's Jonathan and welcome to some Call of Duty Black Ops 6 Zombies. And for today's video, like what the title has said, I think, I'm not too sure because this is pre-recorded, is that I'm going for the zombie diamond camo for my shotguns, and also when I get those done, I am going to prestige. Already, I know. Yeah! But first off, let's check out what I have to do to unlock the diamond. Well, it's not really called diamond, it's called opal, but yeah, about that. So all I have to do now is get 25 more special zombie eliminations for the ASG 89. I still need to get 30 more for the Marine SP. What the heck does that even mean? I have no idea. Well, besides that, everybody, make sure you subscribe because we're on the road to 2,500 subscribers. Besides that, oh, shut up. Let's get this diamond camo and bing, bada, boom, we'll be A-okay.
God damn it!
You know, I'm sitting here like, how the heck are people already bloody prestiged master, got dark matter camo, and there's me going for the opal camo? But man, I really have to say about Black Ops 6 Zombies, I'm having a really good time playing this. Because like what I did on Modern Warfare 3 of how much bloody zombies I played on that, because I unlocked all the bloody master camos for, well, Modern Warfare 3, multiplayer and zombies. Just playing this just seems to be really enjoyable. Mainly because I absolutely loved playing Cold War Zombies, because I was one of the first people to get to around 100 on Maladitosin, I believe. It's funny to me because I'm playing Liberty Falls more than Terminus for some reason. Could be because this is the easiest map to just go for camo grinding. But I don't mind the maps, like, at all. It's just an enjoyable experience, to be honest. Even though a lot of people are going to be complaining that they want classic zombies in Call of Duty, they're not going to ever bring back classic zombies unless you want to physically change it yourself on HUD settings or whatever you have to do. But I think that's the unfortunate thing that a lot of people have to understand, is that BO3 Zombies is almost 10 years old. And that was one of the last times that we actually had sort of a proper classic zombies mode, and now Treyarch don't really want to focus on that anymore, and they want to focus on this new era, because we do know that Cold War Zombies was one of the most played modes when Cold War came out all the way back in 2020/21. So I understand why a lot of people do get frustrated on classic zombies experience, even though it would be really nice to go back to that old style of zombies. But yeah, we're definitely not going to be getting that ever again, which is sad to say. I feel like somebody's going to be complaining to me like, oh, you don't know what it's like to play OG Zombies. I have over a million kills on BO3 Zombies, and I still say BO3 Zombies is one of my all-time favorite zombie modes out there. People say Black Ops 1 and 2 is good. I go, nah. I absolutely loved Black Ops 3 Zombies. And when Cold War came out, I played through there, and I absolutely loved playing Cold War, especially during those COVID days. And now playing the zombies here, it's like I've been playing this more than bloody multiplayer. It's usually the opposite. I would rather go and play the multiplayer first and get everything done, then go and play zombies after. But this time, I'm like, nah, I'm gonna play zombies first, then go and play multiplayer after, once I get everything unlocked, basically. But I do have to say to all of you, are you playing Black Ops 6 right now? Let me know down in the comments down below. And hey, are you playing campaign, multiplayer, or even zombies like what I'm doing? Let me know as well. Okay, so I'm taking over the video quickly because I am quite shocked on how many people are playing the zombies mode compared to multiplayer and campaign, because I think I read something from Charlie Intel the other day of them talking about the percentage of the player base on who's playing what and what, and they found out that there's a lot of people playing zombies, which I don't blame people for playing zombies, because I think people are getting sick and tired of the whole skill-based matchmaking problem that Call of Duty has had since 2019, I think, even though it's already been in Call of Duty for a very long time, but it wasn't really noticeable. And I feel like at this rate, people just want to sit back and relax and just have fun playing video games instead of sweating their balls off. Okay, let's go back to the video. And goddamn, I gotta say as well, after getting past round 20, it starts to get quite bloody hard. I am really gonna think about what the heck are they doing behind the scenes on the bloody servers, man. Billionaire company, and they got so many games running on one engine now, and it's like, holy shit, man. Stock options, oh, yeah, if I did that with my YouTube career, I'd be a multi-millionaire. And I was also saying earlier that I was getting quite frustrated on how Call of Duty's running off one engine now, and the problem is with that, there's so many games running off it, and it creates such a backlog of the servers that you're lagging on a solo game. It shouldn't be like that. I shouldn't be getting 240 ping on a solo match when I'm playing by myself drinking Monster, for God's sake. But don't worry, I will be doing a full review of Zombies once I, well, get my shit together. But you know what? To make the video a little bit more quicker and more, well, basically satisfying, is let's do a little montage quickly, shall we?
You know what? How about we just do a speed run until we get the elite kills, and I'll be right back.
Oh, there we go.
No, literally a minute later.
Holy shit!
Oh fuck, oh shit, oh boy. Okay, go down here, go down here. Oh, holy shit, this is not broken at all, ain't it? Oh, fuck me.
Oh, yeah, this game's not working at all.
This is what happens when you play so much Modern Warfare 3 Zombies and go,
yeah, this is quite freaking easy when you think about it. Why? Jump, slide, spin around, go here, go here, go here, don't die.
No one can stop me.
Damn.
Man, I gotta say, I have not had this much fun on Zombies in a very long time.
Yeah.
29 more to go.
Yeah,
I said that, 29 more.
Oh my god, I'm stuck. Oh yeah. Oh, mangler.
Oh my god, oh no.
You suck.
Oh,
fuck me.
Why is this better now?
Oh my god, why did I spawn every fucking time?
Oh, fuck me.
Oh my,
that's why I'm number one in the world.
Oh, that's definitely not working at all.
No, not again.
Well, I do mean it's not hard to train the zombies, but goddamn, this shotgun absolutely sucks.
Oh, what the fuck? Oh, for fuck. That definitely worked.
Yeah.
Hey. I can finally prestige if I want to, which I will when I get diamonds.
Mm. I'm 9. What's number 9? That's German for no. It means 9 for me. Oh, for fuck's sake, dog, shut up. This is fucking insane.
Instagram.
And the most funniest thing that happened to me was I paused my recording because this took me 2.5 hours to get done. And I didn't even bother recording the Marine SP gameplay because that took another hour to do. That's the only problem when you do these elite zombie kills, because they don't spawn until after round 10. It's not until round 30 when a lot of more of the elite zombies come and spawn. But most of your weapons are absolute crap. So somehow I was able to record it off my Xbox. So yeah, this is basically the clip right here. Oh crap, I wasn't even oh boy. Oh, so we got Opal.
Ooh,
boy. We finally unlocked Opal camo.
Oh right, we finally unlocked Opal camo for the
ASG89. Okay, so I only need to get 16 more for this and we'll be A-okay.
But first off, let me quickly do one thing.
Yep, yeah, we know what we'll be doing today, boy. Come on, let's do it.
There we go.
Ah, prestige 1.
This game's been out for how long? Like a couple of days.
So before I end this video off, I'm going to quickly go and get the other shotgun done, and I'll be right back.
That took 1.5 hours to finally unlock Opal camo on the bloody second shotgun that I needed.
Oh my god, let's go into multiplayer and see how it looks. I mean, yeah, it doesn't really look that bad at all.
So that's the Opal camo for Black Ops 6 Zombies.
Yeah, I mean, it looks really nice, but multiplayer is definitely better. But hey, I can't complain about that. Like, hey,
something to do.
Was it worth it?
Maybe.
Well, everybody, that is going to be the video for today, and I wanted to say thank you all so much for the love and support on this channel recently, because it's been absolutely insane. And hey, don't worry, we got more Black Ops 6 content on the way, because I'm going to be playing Zombies still and go for the other Opal camos, and I might go to multiplayer later, I'm not too sure. Well, besides that, everybody, I hope you guys have a wonderful day and night. Take care of yourself,
and I'll see you guys on my next video.